Hello, this is Blue Diamond Coasters. I'm joined by
my Austin Krieger, aka Coaster Krieger.
And today we're back, or I'm back at Six Flags America. It's been like since Celebrate America 2021 since I've been here, since I didn't get to come here last year. But this is also your first time here.
Yeah, this is my first time, my second Six Flags park, actually.
Yeah, this is now the second time I've been at Six Flags America with someone for the first time.
Yeah.
So I get to show you around, get you all the credits, minus Mind Eraser, which is just SBNO, I guess. But hoping to have a good Six Flags day, and it's already off to a pretty good start, because so I already have a pass for Six Flags, and you were just going to use the comp tickets we get through Hershey. So we head over here to ticketing to get it, and they told us that we have to wait a few minutes to get ours because their lead isn't there yet. So already is a great Six Flags day. But once we get Austin's ticket, we'll be heading on in and getting him the new credits. All right, it took us probably 20 or so minutes, but we're finally in the park. So actually another thing they're doing today is it is Sensory Sensitive Day. I know Six Flags America, they've been kind of pushing to become like an autism, like, awareness center, but so one of the things they do is they have certain days of the season where they kind of tone down the music. Like you see, there's no music playing. They said back there a few rides might have delayed openings just because they cause a lot of noise. Like I think I looked, Firebird is currently down, probably just because of the noise. But that's pretty cool that they're at least doing that, kind of giving some families an option of the best days to come. I also just saw while waiting in line for tickets, so Hurricane Harbor is a separate entry, and I feel like it's much more confusing for guests. Like, some people, like, they'll come to the park just to go to the water park, but now they have to pay, like, full admission price and then some. Like, I feel like if you're gonna have the water park be a separate admission, you should have a separate entrance for people that just want to do the water park. And then, but then also you can have this entrance for people that want to do both. Austin, so since it's your first time, after each coaster, we're going to ask, what'd you think?
It was excellent. I liked that a lot. Definitely some really intense moments. I still think I like Millennium Force more, though.
Oh, yeah, of course.
But this reminds me a lot of Millennium Force.
Though. This is our we have Millennium Force at home. Here at Joker's Jinx, because Batwing isn't open for another like 20 minutes, so we'll head on here. But yeah, Superman was great in the back row. I still think that's like a super underrated ride, and that airtime hill halfway through was insane. We got like crazy like whip going back down though.
Thank you.
Batwing to open. Just got off Joker's Jinx. What'd you think of Joker?
It's fun. I like Flooded Fear more though, personally.
Yeah.
Specifically King's Islands. I think I like it more than King's Dominions though.
Okay.
Flooded Fear.
Yeah.
That was my third spaghetti bowl coaster.
I prefer this to Flight of Fear just a little bit though. Although if I ever get to Fiesta Texas, maybe I'll think Poltergeist is the best.
Poltergeist.
But yep, now we're just waiting for Batwing to open. Just did Batwing. Also now realizing this is the first time I've been to this park since the Batman came out. It's actually, last time I was here was like the day after, I think it was like the second Batman trailer came out. But yeah, now we got here Colin Farrell.
El Rata Alada.
And then over here you got Paul Dano. But anyway, Austin, what did you think of Batwing?
Oh, that was excellent, actually. My first ever Become a Flying Dutchman. That was actually really sweet. I'm not even being sarcastic about that either. That was actually really good.
Yeah, that was a really good ride. After riding Nighthawk about a month ago, I can say that this is still a bit better, but this Batwing is still really good. I think my best advice I learned from riding both this and Nighthawk is try to keep your head like off against the seat back and limit your head banging that way. Alright, just did back car of Wild One. Austin, how'd you think of Wild One?
I like it. Way overhyped though. It's a good classic wooden roller coaster, nice ace line mark. Seems like it's in good condition despite the fact that it needs a paint job, but it's overrated by enthusiasts, I think.
Yeah. I think that's okay. But now we're actually waiting in a line for once, this time for Raging
Cajun.
Yep. The second coaster that Great America gifted us, and so far their last actual like addition of a coaster.
Actually, I'm glad we're doing this now.
So we're now here in Looney Tunes Movie Studio, currently their only open kids area, and they've already started advertising that this area will soon be home to some new kids rides, or not really new kids rides, but relocated rides from Whistle Stop Park. So this one ride, I guess this one kids ride here will be moved over to here. Gotta get the credit. So, we just did Great Chase. Austin, what'd you think of Great Chase?
I kinda heard a little bit, but like, we met a cool write-off, so.
Oh yeah, the write-off was nice, because we told him we were from Hershey and stuff like that.
Is he enthusiast?
Probably not enthusiast, but just like, you know, we got to like compare our own like hand signals. right, just did Firebird. Austin, what'd you think of the smoothest V&M in Maryland?
It was okay. I mean, definitely not as bad as I've heard it is, but like not that great either. Anything is better than Green Lantern.
Yeah.
That.
I actually like kept my head forward a lot during that, and I made it through the first half without getting a headbang. So I'm like, oh, maybe this has gotten a bit better. Then I hit the corkscrew. I'm like, oh wait, no, it's still trash. Now Austin just has one more credit left here.
One more operation credit.
Well, yeah, I mean, Mind Eraser's closed, but there's one more credit left, and it is RMC candidate since 2011. Roar. So we just did Roar. We were kind of like assigned row second to last. But what'd you think?
Not really my cup of tea.
No, it's not good. Awful even. Please, Six Flags America, RMC it, Titan track it. Frickin' 208, I don't care. Just please do something with this ride.
Probably my least favorite. Probably my second least favorite here inside. Firebird is
hurting
my least favorite.
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure if I put Firebird or Roar lower. I know Mind Racer is my least favorite here. And it's definitely like, I mean, I'm actually kind of glad that Mind Racer is closed, because then you get like a 1-2-3 punch of bad as you're
I'm sort of glad, but also sort of not glad.
Yeah, you're not missing much. But okay. Now that you have all the credits, we're going to go on some flat rides now. Starting, I think, with Wonder Woman.
I've never done a Star Flyer before.
Yeah, so I'll be your first Star Flyer. Wonder Woman. That was pretty fun. What did you think of Wonder Woman?
Wonder Woman's great. Way better than any Windseeker.
Yeah.
This right here, though.
And then, yeah, then we just got off Penguin. Huh?
Best ride in the park.
Really?
Yeah. But it's good. It's unique.
Yeah. I love dogs doing this. I'm glad. We thought it would be closed today, but it's actually open. And I think actually now we're going to head over to Superman and try to do a front row ride on it. All right, just did Ride of Steel in the front row. Okay, that actually might be a front row ride now. That was so good. Like, the airtime hills hit like so strong in the front. These hit strong in the front. It wasn't like super painful either. What do you think?
Oh yeah, definitely front seat ride. Back seat is almost as good, but I don't know what it is with
I'm back here.
I don't know what it is with these instrument coasters, like being, I feel like most of them are front seat rides, to be honest with you, like.
Yeah, also, make sure that when you ride these rides to keep your phone secured. I mean, that must have fell far. I was like, hold on. Because that fell out, like, kind of during the last hill, so that would have gone from, like, there all the way down to there. Yeah, that thing's toast. Yep.
Yeah, where is it? I don't see the phone.
It's right next to that, right below that box. Kind of see, see that like gray box? Look down from it. Right there. It's kind of in the shadow right now, but yeah, that must have took like a big like leap because it fell out during the last airtime hill. So yeah, I don't know if that thing's surviving. So I did manage to go on Harley Quinn. It wasn't that bad. Although if you see all the people exiting, that's actually because I think they just had a protein spill, so they're having to clean that up. But yeah, I feel like definitely it's weird that the bigger Frisbee rides I'm better on, but the smaller ones like Krang at Nick Universe are the ones that actually kind of get me dizzy and sick. I mean, I got a bit dizzy on it, but not like enough to make me get sick. What do you think of that?
Blackwood will always be better. The best Frisbee, in my opinion.
Yeah, Black Widow. Great, pretty good Frisbee, so-so MCU movie. But yeah, Harley Quinn, pretty good. So this is gonna be a first for me. I'm gonna do my very first Larson Super Loop coaster. Or well, not really coaster, but ride. Dang it, Six Flags, now you got me calling these coasters. But yep, I have avoided this for long enough. Now, might as well try it, get it over with. As we're waiting it on, Austin, you think this is a credit?
178, of course.
No, this is not a credit.
Credit 178 for me, Michael.
No, this is not a credit.
I don't know how I feel about this. I'm so curious.
It's not on RCDB, on log ride. It's listed as a flat ride. It's not a coaster. Case closed. All right, just did my first ever Larson Super Loop, Bourbon Street Fireball. I handled that better than I thought I would. Like, although that cycle was way too long, I think after a while I was like, all right, we get it. You can kind of like start to end it now. And I just kind of kept going. But what did you think of that?
Same as you. Handled it well. Just one and done for me.
Yeah.
I was curious. I've never done a Larson Super Loop before. So
yeah. At first I was debating on just like, I was just going to like not do it, just chill over by hurricanes. But then I'm like, you know what? I've been wanting to do a Super Loop for a while. I just got to get it over with. And I did it and they're fine. but not a credit. I don't know why people think that's a coaster. That's not a coaster. That's just like, that's a pirate ship with extra steps. Before we headed out, we did one more ride on Wild One, this time towards the front. I think that was a bit better in the front. Hard to tell. What do you think, Austin? Better in the front or in the back?
I don't get all the hype.
Yeah, that's
it. It's better in the front though.
Yeah. But yeah, I think we've kind of spent all the time really neat here. Plus, I think we're gonna go catch a movie nearby. They're re-releasing Pirates of the Caribbean for the 100th anniversary of Disney. So we saw that they were showing it nearby and we decided to go see it. Might as well see a good theme park movie today. So that does it for our day here at Six Flags America. Overall, this was a typical SFA type of day, you know. Nobody here, barely any lines except for Raising Cajun. And you know, the great coasters are great and the bad coasters are bad. But as your first time being here, what did you think?
It's okay, not as bad as I thought it would be. Definitely, the park needs a lot of work, definitely. But as you said, great coasters are really good, bad coasters aren't so good.
Yeah.
But it's an okay park, flat rides are good. If you get Superman's really good too, as well as Batwing and some others too. I'm glad I came here.
Yeah, you know, every time I'm coming here, I'm like, you know, this park could really use a lot of help. And then every time I come back, nothing really changes. But that just about wraps up the video. If you liked it, make sure to give it a like. If you like this video and you want to see more of it, make sure to subscribe to catch all my other videos. Don't forget to also follow at Blue Diamond Coasters on both Instagram and TikTok. And you can follow
Coaster Creeker, but again.
So anyway, this is Blue Diamond Coasters.
This is Coaster Creeker.
Later.